It's time to fly or die, ladies and gentlemen, because the Flyers win their first game of the season in the Czech Republic, actually. They beat the Chicago Blackhawks by a score of 4-3. And just to start off, before I get into the game nonsense, just the reason why I haven't been making videos the previous couple of weeks. School has been pretty busy, so I really haven't had time to do anything. The channel's not dead. No, I'm not doing that again. Not going into hiatus. It's just a lot of work, a lot of stress. Haven't been able to just sit down here and talk to the camera. Just really haven't been able to do that. But as I digress, going into the first game of the season for the Philadelphia Flyers, I wasn't going to miss this for a heartbeat. And of course, they played in the Czech Republic, which means it starts at 2 o'clock here. And I was at school the entire time, so I had class before this. My class ended like 10 minutes before the game started. Go out to grab a quick lunch, come back in, sit in one of the classrooms, open my MacBook, put on NBC Sports Philly live stream, and just wait for the game to happen. Because I also had like a meeting before this too at like 3 o'clock. So during the entire meeting, I'm like this the entire time, to just like glancing at the screen, just like, okay, yeah, just looking at the screen the entire time. But going back to the game, in the Czech Republic, Flyers playing their global series against the Chicago Blackhawks. Let's not talk about the one that they played against the one of the Swiss teams. We'll throw that in the trash. Don't want to talk about that whatsoever. But they come to the Czech Republic, Jake Voracek's hometown, has a ton of family at this game. And just a really nice sight to see a lot of Chicago Blackhawks fans traveling, a lot of Flyers fans traveling over to the Czech Republic to see this game in action. And honestly, at first I thought this was going to be on an Olympic-sized rink, but thank God it wasn't. It was on an actual NHL-sized rink. So that's a good thing. But going to the game, really nice scenery, and just starting off, just I was going to do a Flyers season preview video, but with school being busy, I'm going to do it, but it's like it's going to feel weird after recapping game one. But I don't know. But actually, let's get into the damn game for once. So the Flyers, to start off with this new system from Alain Vigneault, it looks a lot different than what we have been used to with someone like Dave Hackstall, Scott Gorin. Alain Vigneault brings his very upbeat tempo type of play style to the team. We see this in his previous stints with the Rangers, with the Vancouver Canucks. He really brings an up-paced tempo, really wants to play physical, win the puck battles, and just be the faster team on the ice. Be the team that's always 100% when they're on the ice. And the Flyers, I would say, looked more like the better team on the ice today. They looked a lot different. They played at a high pace, and there was a little sloppy play, in there. You're going to expect that. It's the first game of the season. But the Flyers and the Blackhawks, first period was really, really sloppy. But as time went on, both teams looked like they started to get back into the swing of things. And the Flyers, they do get the first goal of the game. It comes off the stick of Travis Konecny. He steals it off the defender, comes up the left side, puts it right past Crawford's glove for a 1-0 Flyers lead. But as a typical Flyers, the lead doesn't hold for a minute later. Alexander Nylander steals it off of Provorov, uses the defenseman as a screen, puts it right by Carter Hart to make it a 1-1 game. And it's funny too, after the Konecny goal, everyone was screaming 82-0, 82-0, the Flyers are Stanley Cup champions. And after this Nylander goal that happened right here, oh, it's back to the same old, same old. And you just can't win with the Flyers fan base on Twitter. It's actually a pretty funny sight. So first period overall, just sloppy play, a little bit back and forth, but it looked like teams were starting to pick up the pace as the period was starting to get over and done with. Some goalies making some big saves. Carter Hart on that Nylander goal probably would want that goal back, but I would say overall in this game, Carter Hart did look pretty good. Bounced back from the sloppy start that he had in against the Swiss team, but overall, he wasn't great, but he made important saves in this game. So let's go to the second period. The Flyers get a power play almost midway through. It's a little bit of a fluky play. It's on the second power play unit. Oscar Lindblom on the left side shoots it. Goes off of Crawford, then bounces to one of the defenders and bounces into the net. I think this is what happened because, remember, I'm sitting like this and peeking over to the screen. So I really don't know what happened on that play specifically, but that's what I saw off the replay. So Oscar Lindblom gets his first of the season to make it a 2-1 Flyers lead. And then we're going near towards the end of the second period. Travis Konecny, with a brilliant play on a 4-on-4, brings it up, toe drags it past the defender, brings it to his backhand, and puts it right over Crawford's glove to make it a 3-1 lead. But going towards the end of the period, this is still in the 4-on-4, transitioning into the Blackhawks power play. A little bit of a passing play. Flyers are a little late to get back into coverage. Kane to Alex DeBrincat for a one-timer, goes right by Carter Hart, and it's a 3-2 Flyers lead after two. And honestly, I wasn't panicking, because the way the Flyers were playing this game, I felt confident enough that they could either get a goal, get an insurance goal to win, or just close it out from there. It looked pretty different. I'm more confident with the system that Alain Vigneault brings than more to say what Dave Haxtell, Scott Gorton did. Because when we came to when a team scored late going into the third period, I was more like, oh god, the Flyers are going to cough up the lead instantly in the third period and they're going to lose this game. But I was more confident because Vigneault's a more experienced coach. So I would expect the Flyers to take a better system into the third period instead of just playing on their heels. And it kind of sort of maybe played on their heels, because the Blackhawks really did bring it in that third period, but the Flyers held their own. And they do manage to score a goal midway through the period. It's Michael Raffle, out of all people, on the fourth line. Raffle, he brings it around the right side of the ice, and he wraps it around past Corey Crawford to make it a 4-2 lead. And not really the icing on the cake, because even though that was the last goal of the game for the Flyers, the Blackhawks do get one around like 2.5 minutes left. They pull the goalie to get the sixth man on the ice. And the Flyers, this is what I didn't like to see when, I guess, the net was empty. The Flyers weren't really playing aggressive. They were holding back. They were choking up. And it gave, out of all the people, Patrick Kane on the ice, all this open space to just let a shot go there, and it goes by Carter Hart to make it a 4-3 Flyers lead. But that's where the lead would hold. After that goal, it looked like the defense, after that whole like choking up on the Kane goal, it looked like they were being more aggressive, getting to the puck, trying to win the puck battles and get the puck out of the zone. And they looked a lot better after Kane scored that goal. And we do manage to win this game by a score of 4-3. And I would give the star of the game in the locker room was Travis Konecny. And I would say Travis Konecny right now was the best player on the ice. But overall, I liked what I saw out of every line today. I liked the way that Drew, Hayes, and Voracek played together. I love the way that Lindblom, Couturier, and Konecny played together. Lindblom and Konecny look like they have a lot of chemistry going with each other. Even though we're really used to the first line of Drew, Couturier, Konecny, I feel like Alain Vigneault really wanted to spread out the two top lines to make it more even, because it does feel like the Flyers do maybe have two number one lines playing at 1 and 2. So that might be a little dangerous going into the rest of the season, but it's only game one. And Chuck Fletcher has stated that there's still going to be a ton of changes going next near the home opener. And I would say, going back to the player of the game, Travis Konecny was on a mission today. 2 goals, and I feel like this is going to be more of a, wouldn't say breakout year, even though he kind of already had it, because he's already scored 20 plus goals in his career two times in a row. But I feel like this could possibly be the season that Travis Konecny possibly scores maybe 30, maybe 30 plus, who knows. Playing on the line with Sean Couturier, he's definitely going to get his chances. And the way Travis Konecny skates, he's one of the fastest players on the team. I would say the fastest player on the team. He's going to create his own chances, and he's going to get those scoring chances. He's a dynamic player on the ice. He's one of the best players on our team for a reason. He's going to get those opportunities. And I would say Travis Konecny was the best player on the ice for us. And Carter Hart, like I said earlier, he made important saves, made some big stops in this game off the Chicago Blackhawks. But I would say that goal against Nylander, he would probably want back. But this season is also going to rely on Carter Hart, how stable he can be in net. Because there definitely are going to be some growing pains with this kid. He's only, 20, 21 years old? Yeah, you're going to expect some growing pains. And just, I was planning on doing a season review video, but haven't had time with school, so I'm probably going to do that within the next day or two, since we got 4 days off until the home opener, and that's why I'm taking this first game one day at a time, because it's 4 days off, home opener, then the next week, we go right to Western Canada. So taking it one day at a time right now, but really love what I saw out of the Flyers today. Really loved this game. Sadly, it was at 2 o'clock and I had to watch it in school, but hey, the Flyers win. We're 1-0 in the season. The road to 82-0 starts right now. So, what are your thoughts on this game? What are your thoughts on Travis Konecny's game? What are your thoughts on the Flyers' look overall? Because overall, they looked a lot different than what they played under Dave Hackstall and Scott Gordon. What are your thoughts on Carter Hart's game? And what do you think the Flyers can bring this season? So, don't forget to leave a comment. Don't forget to drop a like. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next one.